So today we are reading this Shri Shri Siksastaka, verse 3. I think verse 3. Text 37 page.
Trinad api sunichena taror iva sahishnuna amanina manadena kirtaniya sada hari. Trinad, like a blade of grass, api, even, sunichena, being low, taro, as a tree, iva, just as, sahishnuna, being tolerant, amanina, not being proud, manadena, by giving honor, respect, kirtaniya, to be chanted, sada, always, hari, hari. The holy name of Lord Hari should always be chanted in great humility. One should think oneself to be lower than a blade of grass. One should be as tolerant as a tree. One must offer all respect to others. And one should never expect any honor, respect.
Radha, can you speak a little louder?
Kishori, is this working? Is this working now?
Yes.
Working, okay. Thank you. Just a moment.
Well, you want to use this one?
No, it's fine. I just need to point more up.
More up.
Yeah, like this. Yeah, we'll make
what
some.
Old history. What does it mean? Something must be included.
Always, sada.
Always.
Just a minute. Manadena kirtaniya sadahari. This is.
He read it written all respect. What is included inside?
All respect. Just a minute. It's not to offer all honor to others.
It means not only outside, inside. Or else I don't know. It's
in
all respect.
No, all honor.
All honor. Honor, I read respect because honor and respect.
Honor
and respect.
No, yeah. Ask.
Hmm. They will tell us. Want to read it?
Yeah. Right? This purport.
Mm-hmm. Okay, let's read once again.
Mm.
The holy name of Lord Hari should always be chanted in great humility. one should think oneself to be lower than a blade of grass. One should be as tolerant as a tree. One must offer all honor, respect to others. And one should never expect any honor, respect for oneself. Commentary by Anantadas Babaji. Before revealing this third verse of the Siksastakam, Sriman Mahaprabhu, who is dissension, who purifies the age of quarrel, told Sri Swarupa Damodar and Ramananda Rai, O Swarupa, O Rama Raya, listen to the means by which the holy name can awaken prema, love of God. The holy name of Lord Hari should always be chanted in great humility. One should think oneself to be lower than a blade of grass. One should be as tolerant as a tree. One must offer all honor to others. One should never expect any honor for oneself. At the end of Adi Lila of Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita, Srila Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami writes the following verse. Raise your arms, all you people, and listen. String this verse on a thread and wear it as a necklace around your necks. When a speaker wants to reach people who are far away from him, he speaks out loud with raised hands, so that everyone will notice him and pay attention. And in this way, Srila Kaviraj Goswami says to all chanters that they should wear this verse around a neck, just like one's neck beads. If a chanter does not follow this formula, it will be difficult for him to attain the results of Nama Sankirtana.
Okay, we will stop first this sentence. Actually, this third verse is two versions, as far as I know.
Two versions?
Of this sentence. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, this is mentioned, Tunadapi Sunyetena Taro Ribasa Hishnuna. But some other version is Tunadapi Sunyetena Taro Rapi Sahishnuna. Anyway, meaning same.
Mm-hmm.
So this Ananta Baba following Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel this verse is for sadhaka, for practitioner, most important verse for practicing bhakti. And this last sentence mentioned, it will be, so if one does not follow this verse, this formula, it will be difficult to attain the result of Nama Sankirtana. So then question may arise. What is the result of Nama Sankirtana? So everybody know. Yeah. So what do you think the result of Nama Sankirtana?
First is Chitta Dharpana Marjanam, means purification of the Chitta mind.
Purification Chitta mind.
Bhava Mahadava Gunirvapanam means the desires of enjoyment going down. Then, bhava coming, knowledge about my relationship with my Ishtadevata coming.
Maybe you can.
Kairo Chandrika Vitaranam. Kairo Chandrika Vitaranam means the knowledge of my relationships coming. It's fortune. Vidya Vadu Jivanam. But I do not understand this difference, not remember, because in one hand this blue lotus of fortune is blooming under influence of moon. For me it's like bhava coming, mood is coming.
Yeah.
But vidya vadujivana means knowledge of, means it's sambandha. Who am I? I am maitsurna Srimati Radhika. With understand, with not just understand abhimana's feeling coming. Vidya vadu jivanam anandam buddhi vardana means ananda only growing, not going down, always growing. And ananda buddhi vardanam prati padam purnamrita svadanam. Each step giving so much asvadanam. Asvadanam means it's so much tasty. Then devotee is going singing or chanting japa. He's receiving so much ruchi. Prati padam purnamrita svadanam sarvatma snapanam. Sarvatma means all soul completely purified by this nectar. Sarvatma snapanam param vijayate. Vijayate means complete. Vijaya means complete win. That this soul will be, how to say, surrender completely. All, nothing will be left, because win, vijaya means complete win, not partly win, complete. This seven results.
I see. Okay, Andrew, what do you think this the the result of Nama Sankirtana?
Seems like here. This sentence here. Seems that O Svarupa, O Rama, listen to the means by which the holy name can awaken prema. Seems like this, for me, prema means everything what you told and more.
I like this.
Okay. You
can. If someone following this, Sankirtana means he received these four results.
Mm.
Humbleness, tolerance, giving respect to others, because prema giving these qualities.
Wow. So, okay, what you want to say, Andakaji?
Yeah. So, sometimes we are, how to say, stuck. Like, oh my God, I'm not humble. Oh my God, I'm not respectful. What now? Oh my God, I want respect for me.
Every day. Like, when I'm distributing prasad, I see in my heart so much feelings, which is not humble, not sweet.
Then we are concerned so much about these details. But to me, it seems that if we just concentrate, okay, let's just go for the goal.
Hmm.
And not be too disturbed. Yeah, oh, I'm so fun, I'm so this and that.
To have hope and be happy, then to suffer from people.
Obstacles left and right. For me, it's this prema is like all inclusive best. All the best. All solutions are there, all the best is there, all best feelings are there, all best perspective for self-realization and seva for Ishtadevan, like this. So yeah, for me this, just keep love for my Ishtadevan. Well, then everything is included, all desires. We desire humility, we desire Vidyavadu Jivanam, Vijayate Shri Krishna Sankirtanam. So yeah, for me it's like this. Keep one point, this highest one point, then like this.
Yes, very nice. very nice. So, sure, you want to? Okay.
About the So now, you are asking to us what is the result of Nama Sankirtan, and come to my heart. The result of Nama Sankirtan is Unnato Jivararasa. Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu want to distribute Unnato Jivararasa, means Manjari Baba, then may question arise. Now, Andakaji said, Swarupa Damodara Ramanandaraya. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Swarupa Damodara and Ramanandaraya, prema. Why prema? Not Manjari Baba, not mentioned, because Swarupa Damodara and Ramanandaraya is Larita Saki and Vishakha Saki. That's why he didn't say Unnato Jivararasa, just a prema. This is correct, or I don't know, this come to my heart.
Very nice point. So Radha Charanji describes process of bhakti, how to attain prema. And then Andakaji was explained fifth Purusharta, prema. And Kishori was saying, maybe we can say more. Maybe Unnato Jivararasa, maybe Manjari Baba. But this does not mention Manjari Baba because of Swarupa Damodara and Ramanandaya. So my understanding is like this. If we have this quality, means very humble, very great humility, and then oneself to be lower than great grass, and should be tolerant as a tree, and offer all respect, all honor to others, and never expect anything from others. Then we may get fifth Purusharta, prema. And this prema is generally speaking, but prema is including also in broad sense, prema including sneha, mana, pranaya, raga, anuraga, and mahabhava. And finally, madanakya mahabhava. So, actually, Kishori is saying is true. But this is, I think this is broad meaning of prema. Also, according to one's desire and consciousness, different thing we may get. For example, there is five kind of rasa: shanta, neutral, dasha, like a servanthood, and sakya, friendly relationship, and vasarya, and you know, like a parents and son relationship, and madhurya, lovers relationship. So our intention, our likening, and also our, how do you say, tendency, natural tendency, and our consciousness, we can get to whatever we want. Because this name is Parambijayate Sri Krishna Sankirtan. Means we can get whatever we want. So my understanding is this, including Manjari Baba, but just to say, generally speaking, and if someone want to have Manjari Baba, also you can get it. Somebody want to, you know, Saki Baba, also you can get it. If you want to Basara Baba, you can get. You can get anything, even material desire also you can get. But if we attain prema, then all this good quality, we can have it. Or if we have, in this mood we chant, easy to get prema, because no offense. Offense means we are thinking, you know, like abhiman, we have like a purusha abhiman. I'm a master, and I'm enjoyer. And I can do anything. Whatever I belong, this body is mine. This kind of mentality we may have. So that mentality we may commit offense. But in this mood, because always respect others, never ask anything from others, very great humility. And Anandasubha mentioned, humility and love is almost equal. If we have love, we are very humble. If we have very humble, he may have love. So that is my humble understanding.
This what's the result is pratipadam purnamrita svadanam and then sarvatma snapanam param. What does mean sarvatma snapana? Means completely purified. Means no any alloyed, any unalloyed. No other moods. What Gurudev was teaching us. No Sanchari Bhava. Now it's completely fixed. Sthai Bhava. And why? Because pratipadam purnamrita sadnam. He is asadnam. He has so much ruchi taste for his, how to say, that mood which is for him. He is not enjoying other moods, no root for other moods. He's here in Harikatha, or in this case, Radhe Radhe Kirtan of Radha's name or Radha Mohan's name is given these moods. I remember in commentary of Ananda Babaji Maharaj, he told that Sankirtan of Radha's name given everything. Everything. All ingredients which needed for Manjari Sadhana. Manjari Baba Sadhana.
Yeah, actually, this is including Manjari Baba Sadhana. And also Mahanidhi Baba say, we are asking, how can we chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra for getting Manjari Baba, Baba Urasanasa? His answer is, we should have Abhiman, I'm Manjari, I am Dasi of Radhika. In this consciousness, we have to chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra. This is his answer. So what kind of consciousness we have before chanting or during chanting? That is also kind of, you know, at that time we fix in one bhava, sthayi bhava, then we may get it. If we are sanchari, it takes some time, or we may not get it.
Okay. Mm. Radha, devotees.
Oh, okay, okay, please, please.
Mm. Gora?
Yes?
Wow, wow. Our Stein, Mr. Stein.
No, no. I like the topics very much you speak about today. And actually, I also like to add a little bit from my bhajan. I think the result of chanting the holy names is the goal should be to become a bridge Parsi, an inhabitant of Vrindavan, right?
Mm.
This should be our goal. In our case, it's a Manjari, but actually there are many who are chanting the holy names, but the goal has to be always for everybody to become an inhabitant of Vrindavan. If you are become an inhabitant of Vrindavan, automatically you lose your identification of the material body and material concept. You no longer think that you are this and that. So you lose all kind of proudness, and automatically you become these qualities what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is explaining in the Siksastakam. So if you are identified as an eternal spiritual soul, as inhabitant of Vrindavan, so what is all the meaning of this material world? You give up all this and you become Trinada Pisunichina. You become humble because you don't think, I am the king, I am the boss, I am this and that. So you are feeling so much mercy to all living beings that you give respect to everybody because you see Krishna in the heart. That is Trinada Pisunichina for me, to become an inhabitant of Vrindavan and see the material world from this view. What Gurudev said from the garden house. Then you get the mercy of this quality is what is actually Mahaprabhu speaking about. And automatically, if you become inhabitant of a bridge of Vrindavan, prema is inside. Because you see everything, like Raghunath Das and Rupa describing. They are Nitya Siddhas, they are in contact, eternal. And they can describe, this is the quality of one who is living there, that he can describe the pastimes of Radha and Mohan. And then, this is the quality of Nitya Siddha. They are eternally together with them, and they can pick up us and bring us there. This is also the quality of them. Who can describe the eternal pastimes? Only one who is there. So, we can become this, and if we do our bhajan properly, by the mercy of our Gurudev, and then we can go to that place of eternity. And we also become eternal. Now we are temporary. And we are identified with our body and situation in the material world. And because of this, we are too proud to be like grass, humble, or like a tree. But in that moment, we accept ourselves as an inhabitant of Vrindavan. Then we are automatically humble and we see this world different. So the goal of bhajan should be to become an inhabitant of Vrindavan, eternal. And then all other things will come automatically. This is what I can see to this point. It's maybe very simple, but yes, if we get the sthayi bhav, Jayananda, then maybe it will become possible. And the sthayi bhav we get from our Gurudev. Radhe, Radhe.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
You remember we are Brajavasi. And following Brajavasi, especially, you know, and Sri Radhika and our Manjari. Or if somebody, any, you know, other people, other devotees want to share, please, always welcome.
Okay. Okay, we will continue.
So Gurudev, if you could say something, if you...
Beautiful, everything is very nice. All very nice. Beautiful. There is no difference between name and the person. So Nami and name is no difference. So this is the love we say and we reach to our sthayi bhav. Without name, a sthayi bhav not come. Without mercy of Braja, a sthayi bhav not come. Without mercy of sadhus and Vaishnava, and Guru Kripa, sthayi bhav not come. This is the way to come to the check my confusion question. Sadhak Deha has to be loving. Then it comes to the point.
Thank you very much.
Loving.
Yes, sir.
Okay, we continue reading. In the previous verse, it was discussed that there is nothing else but offenses that prevents the full power of the holy name to manifest itself. Here, Sriman Mahaprabhu teaches all the people of the world that the only way to protect oneself from offenses is to chant the holy name with great humility. When Mahaprabhu instructed Srila Rupa Goswami, he compared offenses committed against the devotees to a mad elephant that uproots the tender vine of one's devotion from the heart. there is no other way than to fence off one's wine of devotion with the shield of humility. We find in Chaitanya Charitamrita, one should build a strong wall of humility and protect one's vine of devotion by giving honor to others around it, sprinkling the vine with the water of hearing and chanting. Humility.
Can I share something? Just when you said this beautiful sentence about about building a wall of humility, I just felt to share what is this wall of humility. And I felt that it's actually our Gurudev, because it's this deep understanding that any spiritual growth, or material for that matter, that I have in my life is only coming because of the grace of my Gurudev. And when we know this, when we understand this, then we become naturally humble. And we know that anything that happens is not because of my doing, it's because he is doing. And he is the one who puts that wall to protect our spiritual life. He is the one who waters. He is the one who takes out the weeds. He is the one who gives us favorable association. It's all our Gurudev's mercy. It's not my doing. And when we see this very clearly, then automatically his wall, which he is building, you know, it naturally protects us also. So, yeah. Just wanted to share this. Radha, Radha.
Wow, beautiful. Gopika Didi. Gopika Didi. So because Gurudev drink our false ego. And Gurudev always give shelter. And chatra and charana seva. Gurudev is everything. Gurudev protect everything. Gurudev is everything. Gurudev be war. Gurudev be mother. Gurudev is father. Gurudev is my master. Gurudev is my friend, my dear friend. Gurudev for everything. So Gopika Didi share very, very nice things.
Radhe, Radhe. Yes, Gopika, oh. So nice. Thank wow. You for sharing. I also want to give a little bit what I had at this moment. I was thinking, yes, this humility is such a good protection, because first of all, I don't feel that I am something special or something high or something very smart or realized. That is a general understanding. But I was thinking also of Haridas Thakur. When he was doing his bhajan, then also there were so many tests.
And especially also one lady came who wanted to make him fall and try to catch his attention. But what he said, yes, yes, I will fulfill your desires. Just wait until I have finished my prescribed Harinam or my, you know, bhajan. So he was also so sweet in that this lady listened to his chanting, and in his association, she became slowly, slowly so softened and melted in her heart. And this is also what Gopika said, that when Gurudev is giving all this protection by the power of, you know, their love and their dedication, then also us who are more or less like an insect, or like how I feel sometimes, very insignificant, we get also blessed by this vibration, and then no more obstacles, because slowly, slowly we also become purified and clean and soft-hearted, and ego is out. And Harinam, or the holy name of what we were hearing today, so powerful. When we hear this from the powerful source, also this projection comes to my heart, even to this lady who tried to make a big obstacle in Haridas Thakur's bhajan. So this is also what I felt was a very nice thing, that this is a protection. The humility is a protection. And at the same time, we don't offend anyone anymore. We just say, yes, yes, I will fulfill your desires. Just wait a little bit. I thought this was also so sweet of Haridas Thakur. He always makes everyone happy. And so also Gurudev always make everyone happy. Yes, yes, you will get everything. Just wait, just wait. So like this, we are protected also. Jai Shri Radhe.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Suniti.
Humility. Humility means to naturally, always consider oneself to be very unqualified. Humility means to naturally always consider oneself to be very unqualified. Srimad Sanatana Goswami defined humility as follows in his Brihad Bhagavatamrita. The wise men call humility that feeling which makes the most qualified person consider oneself to be low and unqualified. Intelligent practicing devotees should follow in the footsteps of those in whose hearts this humility is fixed, with their words, activities, and intelligence, and they should never act contrary to this. the above mentioned humility, which makes the most qualified person consider oneself to be low and unworthy, is not ordinary humility. It is the natural condition of a surrendered soul who has illuminated his spiritual self by returning to his constitutional position. Humility is the natural condition of a surrendered soul who has illuminated his spiritual self by returning to his constitutional position. When a fortunate person who has surrendered to the Lord's lotus feet by the mercy of a bona fide teacher advances on the path of devotion, he will experience the authority of God more and more as the dense darkness of his false bodily consciousness vanishes and his real identification as God's servant awakens. Ultimately, the practicing devotee will give up all his own false authority, throwing it into the ocean of God's authority by means of full surrender to the Lord's feet, and in this way becoming a liberated soul. As long as one is in his material body, he will have to deal and speak with people of the world. But as soon as he senses even the slightest feeling of personal authority coming up in him, he feels greatly upset. An urge of humility will arise in his heart, and he will at once give up his false feeling of authority. That is natural humility of a devotee. And the valuable treasure of a devotee's sadhana, spiritual practice. Srimad Sanatana Goswami says that there is not much difference between humility and devotion. Both are impetuses for each other. The holy name will be pleased with such humility of the devotee, and in this way all offenses to the Vaishnavas will vanish. In this way, humility attracts the mercy of the holy name.
So this is, I think, this is a very important point. This say, Baba say, holy name will be pleased with such humility of the devotee. Because Baba mentioned just a little bit before, there is not much difference between humility and devotion, means bhakti. Or sometimes other place, he's saying humility and kind of bhakti, or sometimes prema, is not so much different. Someone who has bhakti, holy name will be pleased. Someone who is love, Gurudev will be pleased, or Vaishnava will be pleased. Then, all offense to the Vaishnava will be banished, Baba mentioned. The humility attracts the mercy of the holy name. Or maybe we may say, the humility attracts the mercy of Vaishnava. Or maybe Gurudev. Because someone who has bhakti, automatically devotee also attracted. So this is why humility is important. This is Baba is very nicely explained, I feel.
So Gurudev, last two sentences or a little bit more? Srimad Sanatana Goswami says that there is not much difference between humility and devotion. Both are impetuses for each other. The holy name will be pleased with such humility of a devotee, and in this way all offenses to the Vaishnavas will vanish from the heart. In this way, humility attracts the mercy of the holy name. Our eyes are very tender. Still, they are
Comment.
Radha, I'm sorry.
Please,
Sorry.
Vandanaji.
Is it okay?
Sure. Welcome. Always welcome.
I feel what Gopika said before about her feeling sharing that Gurudev is actually this humility when we really connect and really understand. And I feel it is given on this the next sentence, actually, so astonishingly, that if we follow somebody in the footsteps of those whose hearts is fixed in humility, with the words, activities, and intelligence. So it is for me like, yeah, it's very true what she said. So right, this is Gurudev. And then also I feel how is continued what you said before. That it's Kishori Didi shared why he's not talking about Manjari Bhav. It is coming in the next part also. So this when this humility really awakens and one really surrenders, it's becoming like this is the illumination of the spiritual self. And he will return to his constitutional position. I don't know if this means actually to realize I'm an eternal connected soul with a form that always wants to serve Guru Manjari and Radha and Krishna. Please tell me if I understand wrong. Sorry, Radhe. On page
I could not hear.
Vandanaji, could you say again, because here the voice is not clear. Could you say again about
question?
Not here. And then listen, like Kishori, you have to stay in microphone. And Wandan also, please talk.
No, I just found it very remarkable that what Gopika so nicely shared before about recognizing Gurudev actually being this fence that protects us, that is the humility. And because we get all the good influence by his mercy. And I found it remarkable. It was coming in the text, actually, just the sentence afterwards. So if we follow a qualified person that is in his footsteps, whose heart is fixed in humility, with his words, activities, and intelligence. So, and this is Gurudev, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then before Kishori Didi talked about why he is not talking about Manjari Bhav. And I feel it's coming in the next paragraph that it's the natural condition of a surrendered soul to come in his constitutional position. And I was wondering, does this mean actually to realize that I'm an eternal soul who has a form and who's always in service to Guru Manjari and to Radha and Krishna? Yes. So this is my question, if this is the wrong understanding.
Which is the question?
You confirm, Gurudev?
Yes.
Vandana, my dear, so nice that you are sharing. Thank you. I love to hear you. I very much appreciate. I also feel that you are right when you are saying that constitutional position here means Manjari Swarup in the same way as Gurudev is always sharing with us what is meaning of constitutional position. For pointing this out.
Is
So what I see, there is a false ego, there is no humility. And when there is no false ego, the person is out from false ego, he is very humble, humility is there. That is devotion. I remember my one brother, Mohan Baba. I was in Barsane with him. And one person, he has no utensils to clean the and to cook anything. So one devotee bought 20,000 rupees pots and he bring to the ashram of Mohan Baba and he give Baba, I bring the nice utensils to cook there. Mohan Baba said, very good. And they are cooking. After 10 days I was there, so after 10 days there is again no utensils. All is finished. Then all devotees is surprised, is not there. And say, Baba, I know where it's gone. He was listening, close eyes. And he said, Baba, when we are cleaning, we put in the river. Because there's too much pots to clean. So one by one, we put it in the, this pili pokhar. So we have less pot to clean and cook. Yes, Baba, I'm watching. He said, no problem. And I said to Baba, you see my false ego. I say, Baba, you have to control it, manage it. He said, yeah, I will say this. And he never say that why you do this. So this is the humility. And my false ego was telling, why not you control and manage? So my ego was this, and his humility was that he listened and he asked to the any devotee why you do it. This is devotion. By listening humility, I understand what is humility and what is false ego. Because his bhajan was more deep, he was so humble, he don't bother for material thing. And my bhajan was not good. So I was not humble, I am living in my body, the identification. And I say, why you do this, man? We are brother, no? And he love me and I love him like a very friendly. You cannot imagine our friendship. And I say, it's crazy about how he will manage his manage the ego and their humbleness, we don't bother for this. So when I see money and he sees the bhajan, humility, that is his bhajan and that is his devotion.
Also, one time, Gurudev, you told a story when somebody came down when you were doing the reading. Mm. And they start to argue against and say,
I see what they write. Yeah. What they...
I don't know if I...
But Gurudev was telling one time this story that he and Radha Mohan Baba were together, they were reading and sharing very deep subjects, Vilap Pusumanjali. And then one devotee came.
No, he's teaching me that he's teaching about the humility. He's sharing that, teaching what? Sharing me that this has to be important in our bhajan, to how to be. Do this.
Practically,
how to go in this bhajan. Radha Dasyam. So we are talking, and one person, I mean, in within 5 minutes, and he start talking about the management and the Baidhi Bhakti and other thing. Then he said, wow, you are very perfect. You are very nice, very good, very good. And this, that. And then he said, sorry, I have to go someplace. And he has nothing to go. Then he's lying. He says, sorry, I have to go someplace. So we will meet again. 10 minutes. Then I say, are, why you lie to this guy? He said, you're wasting my time. I said, why you agree with his point? Then he said, why to waste my time for this? Argue to him, he will never understand. So I say, yes, 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 very good, very good. And I escape myself. So sadhu means, what is sadhu who no waste his time for useless things? And who is humble, who don't bother for anything. Humility is a spiritual thing, is a devotional thing. Humility without devotion not come. Is not in a false ego identification. Humility cannot come there. Without humbleness come is a devotion. Greed come with that when humbleness is coming. So I feel very guilty myself when somebody come for something, I judge to them. Still my judgment is there. Still I have to practice humbleness. And this is a very important subject, to be more humble. Yeah. Thank you. So I say, repeat again this practice I want to do in my life, to to improve my life and greed in my life. Thank you.
Okay, we will continue reading. So Ananta Baba writes, our eyes are very tender, and still they are the most important of the knowledge acquiring senses. And because even the slightest thing can cause great damage to them, the Lord has created our eyelids to always protect our eyes.
See? You see that? You want to protect everything in my falsehood. Repeat, Mary. Wow, I think this is poetry. Yeah, again, repeat this.
Our eyes are very tender. Yet, they are the most important of the knowledge acquiring senses.
Knowledge acquiring senses, true senses, false ego,
judging,
checking. Yeah. Go on.
And because even the slightest thing can cause great damage to them, the Lord has created our eyelids to always protect them.
So they make me gatekeeper to manage this. Again, my checking come here. To get me, I give you a gate now. You are living in basement, you not see anything. No, I keep you on the road. Only you check the traffic and check the person. And now gate man is gone. So I have to be gate man also to check and protect. My eyes become more bigger. You see, my ego is going to grow. I will say to Gopinath to put one curtain to not see anything here. Please, you have request to Gopinath to put the curtain. My God, this is all my teaching here. They put me in gate, Gopinath. You become gatekeeper now. I go backside and I will relax myself.
I will hide in the room.
Yeah, you see? And this is my checking. What you progress, still you are in the condition, false ego condition. You see, my condition is this, my dear. Sorry. You are teaching for me, my dear. Thank you. Radharani put me in the gate by inspiration to Gopinath that you do room this here. That I, what is my situation? Still I am in that condition. Please pray. I say that all Vaishnava has to help me. You see? Please, I need help. Yeah.
Radhe, Radhe.
Radhe. Yeah.
make me laughing. Gurudeva, you make me laugh. We don't. It's good therapy for you laughing. That's like, we are helping you.
Yeah. Yeah.
Laughing is very good. It's a beautiful therapy. Right or wrong? What you say is a good therapy of laughing and loving. I make this question to all the devotees over there. You think about it in your consciousness. Love in action. All this, it's a romance. Now we have to make in action.
Real, more real.
I want to make one question too. What is for you making in love in action? This question.
No, please.
Good, a request to read.
If you read or you talk, you say.
No, I don't know.
Because you are making commentary, and then more commentary comes.
Yeah.
More reading, more commentary.
Yeah, just reading, and I don't know so much loving action.
How are you?
Yes.
So,
Tami.
Just come.
Yeah. If by chance a speck of dust falls on the eye, the fine nerves in the eye immediately produce water to drive the dust out of the eye's realm. In the same way, humility drives out the offenses that hamper our devotion. And humility make our hearts free from them. With this verse, Trinad Apisunichena, Sriman Mahaprabhu...
Free from offenses
that hamper our devotion.
Yes. Yes. Go on. Okay. Loudly say, it's not coming out.
With this verse, Trinad Api Sunichena, Sriman Mahaprabhu teaches the practicing devotees how to observe the highest humility. Humility is the very life force of the chanting of the holy name. Without chanting, without humility, is lifeless. Therefore, the chanter must become specifically acquainted with these great words of Sriman Mahaprabhu. The Lord said, Trinad Api Sunichena, the practicing devotee should feel as humble as a blade of grass. Blade of grass is very insignificant thing, but it is still very important, since it serves the cows as a foodstuff. And through that, the cows give milk, with which the Lord can be served. Roofs of houses and temples can also be made with grass. But the devotee should think, no service has ever been done through me.
Well, just maybe you can do it.
In this way, devotee considers himself to be even lower than a blade of grass.
So this is Ananta Baba, Anantas Vaj Maharaj was very, very poetic and very nice thing. I was feeling this a blade of grass. This is important to serve. Blade of grass serves a cow as a food stop, and through that cow gives milk, with which the Lord can be served. I was felt like a humbleness, very humbleness, give us like a milk, give like a prema. So humbleness is like a, not food stop, but a humbleness, we could serve the Lord, and then this produce prema. I was felt. And also this one is very important. I felt the devotee should think no service has ever been done through me. Because the devotee has no horse ego, no ownership, no dual consciousness. I'm just a viewer. Just by the mercy of the Lord, by the mercy of Gurudev, actually this have done by the mercy of Gurudev. Gurudev is doing this through me, not me. I'm not doing, but by the mercy of Lord, by the mercy of Gurudev, I'm just an insignificant puppet for the Gurudev. So therefore, devotee is thinking, no service has ever been done through me. That I felt this is kind of humility. But for me, we are thinking, oh, I have done I did this one. We are so proud. I'm so proud. But the real devotee was thinking, oh, actually, this all have done by the mercy of the Lord, by the mercy of Gurudev. I'm not doing anything. I'm just a puppet of Gurudev. I felt this is Ananta's Baba show us real humbleness, and I want to run this one.
The devotee should humbly think, when someone steps on a blade of grass, the grass will rise again after the foot has gone off him. But I never get up so unharmed and unoffended if someone kicks me with a foot. Certainly, these feelings of humility must be developed by the practicing devotee. As long as one does not realize one's lowness with one's heart and mind, and only feigns humility on the outside, verbally, for instance, the perfection of this Trinad Api Sunichena mood is not attained. Real humility is internal mental humility. There is no greater deceit than to feign humility.
So feign means?
Feign, like false.
False.
Like play.
Okay.
Play humility. A role.
Yeah.
How to say? Pretend. Pretend humility. Through one's gestures and words, but actually being filled with false pride within one's mind. Such false humility will never purify one's heart.
False ego.
Thank you. That means that false humility is false ego.
Yes.
But when I'm in together with devotees and I do like this, and it's not really from the heart.
Yes, I see.
False humility is false ego.
Yeah.
That is false ego.
Thank you.
Not reality. It's a false humility. It's because of my false ego.
Also means that it also means that seva is false. What is Guru Seva? It's not serving the ego of the Guru. It's serving the divine in the Guru. The mercy that the Guru gives doesn't come from his ego. It comes from the divine within him, the mercy that he received. So the devotee as a puppet is not a puppet of the Guru's ego, but a puppet of the divine, or a collaborator of the divine within him. And this is what mercy means. It doesn't start with Guru, it flows through Guru, and from Param Guru, and so on and so on.
I took
for sharing a photo of me. When we spoke about the blade of grass, so the grass is there, and then somebody steps on that blade of grass, and it was compared if somebody kicks me or speaks harsh words to me. And is our wall means if I feel whosoever speaks to me, whatsoever happens to me is the mercy of my Gurudev, then if somebody steps on me, if somebody kicks me, if somebody beats me, if somebody praises me, if somebody, whatever somebody does, I feel now Gurudev is trying to teach me something so that I can be more humble in my life. And in this way, Gurudev becomes our wall, because we know that it's mercy that moves me inside my heart. It's all mercy which moves me. It's his mercy. And as Uddhavaya said, it's that flow of mercy which comes, you know, which comes from his Gurudev. And you know, that whole Guru Parampara, which is always supporting our spiritual growth. So that becomes the true humility. And Gurudev very often gives this very beautiful analogy of a jug and a cup of water. So if you want to pour water in a glass and you keep the glass higher than the jug, then it cannot, no water will come inside. This is the beauty of mercy. When we just know this, that everything which comes in my life is through mercy, then our jug becomes so vast, you know, that we can really receive it also. Gurudev is always pouring, you know. He's like holding the huge bucket and pouring, but we have to dive low to get it, you know. That we have to surrender and receive it from down low. If we want to stand very high, then we will not even get a drop of water on our body, you know. So Gurudev makes it very easy for us because he's so pouring all the time. Yeah. You want to say
something? Radhe, Radhe. Gopika, you just answered my question, which was inside of my heart, because I thought here in Vrindavan, among all our sisters and Gurudev, it's a good place to practice this and to learn and to check ourselves. And what will be when I'm back in the Western country, and then the people, maybe someone is not so friendly and is angry with me, or wants to, how is the English word for, is not correct to me, then to stay humble. Oh, wow. And now you gave this wonderful example, it's the truth, that I always can remember my Gurudev, that he now gives me, through this person, a chance to practice my humbleness. Is that right? Did I understand right?
Yes, my dear. Wonderful. Because actually Gurudev, like Gurudev is also saying so beautifully always, he says that I see my Gurudev in all my disciples and all my surroundings. Is my Gurudev is expanding to teach me. So this is our mood. And we can see that in every encounter that we have. And actually, one time I remember Gurudev said to me, you're the most fortunate, you know, wherever you live in this world, if your worst enemy is your neighbor, because then you can really practice. So if we come with this mood, then any person that we encounter, we can feel that it's Gurudev, and he's trying to, any challenge that comes, it's mercy that it's trying to bring me more deep and more close, you know, to our Swamini, to that which is real. The more unreal we see, the more we can connect to that reality, and it makes us more humble. And if we don't have any tests, if we are always, you know, cuddled and cozy, then we will not know where we are spiritually. So it's good to get challenges. It's good when somebody says something offensive. It's good when somebody tries to kick me, because then I can really see if I learn something from Gurudev or not, you know. Oh, so God, we have to see everything in that positive vision.
Very positive.
Wow, you are so beautiful. Yeah, so beautiful. Now every day when I go out or get up in the morning, I can say, oh, what challenge will be come to me today, and be surprised about it, and hopefully can watch the things, check myself, and practice to become more humble and to become more, to live in love. Thank you. Thank you very much, Gopika.
Wow, beautiful.
So thank you very much. So very beautiful sharing. And now soon, Arctic time will start. So thank you very much.